I'm George Pearson, and these are just a few examples from some of the training videos I have here on YouTube. Now, when you're working with the training, following along the training, if you want to get the materials I used in the training, just go to the description down below and click on the link that's at the top of the description, and this will take you to a page where you can download the materials. Please subscribe, click the like button, and of course always share on Facebook, Twitter, or wherever. I really appreciate that. Okay, let's go ahead and get started with the video. In this how-to project, we're going to be improving this picture in here by replacing the sky and then doing a little bit of work on the image itself. So we'll be beginning with this, and then I'll bring up our sky. I'll be adding this sky to that image and ending up with that. So we've replaced the sky, and we've also improved the colors and contrast in here a little bit as well. Okay, let's go ahead and see how this is done. Just bring that over in front. There we go. Now I'm using floating windows on this. If you don't have floating windows, easy to do. Just go up to Edit, come down to Preferences and General, and make sure that these two links are checked. You can then float or dock your windows. Just dock it like that, or float up by pulling the tab down. Okay, so floating window. We're going to make a selection in here and then use a layer mask on this. Now I have this set up with a copy. I normally will make a copy of my background. Just drag your background up to the new layer button, gives you a copy, and then hide the background. That's just a habit that I'm in. In case I mess this up, I can always go back to my original that's right there inside the file. You can delete that later on if you no longer need that. But there's my copy. And usually on my projects, I'll go in and I will make real careful selections using different selection tools and do real nice clean edges and so forth. Maybe use refine edge on hair, things like that. We don't need to in this one because the sky is relatively even. It isn't perfect, and I'll show you a couple ways of fixing that, but it's pretty good. So we can do this quickly and easily with the magic wand tool. Let me just hide that. I'll move this up. There we go. Now I have mine set at new for a new selection. Tolerance at 21, which is a nice number to start off with, and then contiguous is not checked. They want that unchecked so that you get the stuff in here in between these skids. What contiguous means is touching. So if I clicked in here, it would only give me stuff that's actually touching. It wouldn't get what's inside there. So make sure that's unchecked. I'm going to start just by clicking right down here in the middle someplace, and that gets most of the area. Notice it gets inside the skids, that's what I want. But I need to add the area up here, so let's change this to add right there and click in the middle of that top section. That adds the rest in, and there we go, there's a nice selection. Now what I actually want selected is the helicopter and the buildings, not the sky. So let's go up here to select and inverse. That just reverses that selection. It's now just the helicopter and the sky. And the reason why I want this part selected is it will be removing the sky by using a layer mask. And that's just clicking that layer mask button right there. There we go. It just hides the sky. Now the reason why I did that, one is that it protects this image here. I can always go back to that if I need to make an adjustment. Also, if I want to change what I'm seeing, I can just change the mask over here. Notice how black is hiding the sky and white is showing the buildings and the helicopter. If I wanted to have just the helicopter, I can actually adjust just the mask part here, add black into the area where the helicopter isn't, and will then hide the buildings. So it gives me flexibility. So I'm not damaging the original, and I have flexibility on changing what it is I'm showing. So that's why the layer mask, instead of just erasing. This is always a better way to go if possible. Okay, now that we have this, we can actually just drop a picture in behind that to give us our background. So I'll bring up our cloud image again. There we go. And I'll just grab it and drag it over here. Just drag it on and delete that. Now it's not quite the right size. It's a little bit off, but it's pretty close. So I'll just kind of plop that in position. See, it's a little bit larger than our file, but that's fine. Now I take this and put this underneath the helicopter layer, just drag it down, and there's the sky inside with the helicopter. Looks good so far, but it's not perfect. Let me show you the problem. When we did the magic wand and we had our anti-aliasing, that adds a little bit of a softness to the edge, and that can sometimes give you a little bit of a halo effect. So I zoom in here, See if we have anything showing. Actually, it looks pretty good there. Okay, there's a little bit, a kind of little light line right in here and right up here. Just a little bit of a haloing effect on that edge. It's not too bad. A little bit of a blue line you can see right there. Actually, it's pretty clean on this one. In most cases, I would just leave this alone, but let me show you how this is done. I'm going to drag over here and take a look at the buildings and see how those look. I can see a little bit more of that kind of a halo around that edge on the buildings. Just like a little bit of softness. That's the anti-aliasing and that haloing effect. So I want to minimize that halo effect. Easy to do. And just zoom back out here. There's our whole picture. It's actually not that noticeable in the picture, but we can still make this better. Go over to the layer mask. Look for that light blue outline. If you don't see that, if you're seeing it over here, just double click on the layer mask to see the light blue outline. We're now going to modify the layer mask. And what I want to do is make the black a little bit larger so the black kind of comes into the white area here. That's easy to do. Now, since the helicopter looks good in our image, we're only really seeing a problem with that edge up on the top of this building and a bit over on this building here. Zoom in again and take a look at that. So, helicopter's fine, and it's not that great just up here and just over in that area here and a bit at the top of that. So, I want to modify the layer mask over here and just cut in the black a little bit on these edges. Now, it's a bit tight as you can see, but we can zoom in on this. Let me just show you how this is done. I'll just grab my polygonal lasso tool over here, and I'm going to come in and just very carefully make a little selection that comes just inside that edge, just a touch. Not too far, but just a little bit into the edge. I already don't know what this thing is over here on the side, but I'll just take off a bit of that halo in there. And then come straight up. So you can see there's a little bit of that light line on the left side of my line, and then nothing on the right side, or just a hair on the right side. And then just kind of work along the top edge of the building here, and just showing just a little bit of that edge, the part that you don't want to have in there. And we can then actually paint in black into our new selection. Now, if you hit the top like this, hold the space bar down, you can then move your image over. I'm going to kind of just adjust things a little bit here, make it look a little bit more interesting on that edge. A little more detail that way. Just kind of work along and come right along, right in the edge of that light spot. You know, just come straight down, hold the space bar down again, and just cut off just a bit of that edge. Now, I'm not going to do the whole thing on this. We'll just do just this one building, so I'll show you the technique. And I'll come up just over here, and I'll stop it right about there. And let's just scroll to the top, hold the space bar down, went too far on that. There we go. I need to bring my selection back around to the starting point again here. All right, so this part is now selected, which means that this part is protected. So I go over to my paintbrush and bring the size down quite a bit. There we go. It's a soft brush right now and pretty small. It's 16 pixels on there. So I can now just painting on the mask itself in black. I can paint right along that edge, and that's going to hide that little bit of lightness. Hold the space bar down, you can move the picture around. Just kind of paint along. I'm just expanding out that black just a little bit, just in those spots that need it. Okay, so now deselect. And you see we now have a nice clean edge in there, very little halo going on. You can see our haloing going on over here and no haloing over there because we just expanded our mask out just a little bit to cover that. So to finish this thing off, I would go ahead and finish those steps up there. Actually, that's not too much work. Let's go ahead and finish this off. That's pretty close. So I'll just start right here. And again, just cutting off just a little bit of the part that's too light in there, the part that's giving us that halo effect. And then once that's done, we can paint that out with black, just expanding the black part of our mask. And that hides that little error. Okay, let's do a little bit of detail in here. Obviously, the picture's a little bit out of focus at this part also, which makes it a little bit tough. So I think I'll simplify just a bit in here. Not too much, but a couple little things, maybe a little more interest up there, a bit more detail showing. And space bar, and there's the edge of our picture. And again, we're going to come around like this and close this selection off. Here's our beginning part. Back to our paintbrush, and I'm still on the layer mask, still in black, and then just paint right along that edge just to hide that little bit of a glow that we're seeing. And that will then clean up that edge and make it look much, much nicer. Okay, we'll just deselect that. All right. Now, one more little issue on this one, which you know, may or may not bother you. It's up to you. The background here is in focus. Right there, the clouds, that's all in focus. The helicopter is in focus, but the mid-range area is not in focus. So technically, to make this work, the clouds need to be out of focus. I'm going to show you everything else first. Leave the clouds in focus, then I'll do a clouds out of focus, and you can use whichever one you like better. It really depends, of course, on the final quality of the image. Okay, let's just back out. Now, we could work with our contrast and so forth to try to increase the quality of focus, and that's one of the things we're going to be doing. We're going to increase the apparent sharpness of this part by just playing with our focus a little bit by using a contrast adjustment. But here we go. Now, we have the sky is blue in the background, so it's all blue lighting behind this, which means the sun is behind us, sun is yellow, so we can improve the separation between the helicopter building and the sky by warming up the tone of the helicopter building part of our picture, which is this right here. Let's do that with a warming filter. Go up here to Layer, New Adjustment Layer, and you want Photo Filter. And then make sure you click this. Use Previous Layer to Create Clipping Mask, which means that this will apply this photo filter just to that one layer. And I have mine set for a warming filter here. 85 is the default color. And then just bring that up a bit. This is maybe about halfway, about 50%. That's pretty good. Real nice warm in there. And close it down. We've now warmed that up. If I hide that filter, there's before and here it is after. Notice how much more this separates from the background now. You get a much more distinction in here with those that just warmed up. It just kind of improves that separation and it makes this pop a little bit better with that color contrast. Okay, now let's increase the contrast of this image. See, that makes this look a bit better as well. Same thing, come down here onto the helicopter layer and then layer, new adjustment layer, and levels. Now, the reason why I'm doing this with adjustment layers is so that I can come back and change them later on. I'll show you that in just a second. Choose OK. Here we go. Now, on this, if you bring in the blacks of this, will darken down the black parts like that. If we bring the right side, it brightens up the light parts. So by pulling these two ends in, it increases the contrast values of the picture, and that increases the effect of it being in focus. So there we go, little adjustment. That's 24 and 237 if you want to match that exactly on my settings. And there it is. Let's just go ahead and see how we look at this point. I didn't want to dock that. There we are. I'll grab our background layer. Another reason to keep that background layer saved. drag it up here to a new layer button. There's a new copy of that. I'll show that. Bring it up on top. So there's the original, and here's our change. So we've dramatically improved that picture, as you can see, just by adding in those clouds. Now, the last thing, as I mentioned, because the buildings are a little bit out of focus, you may want to have the clouds a little bit out of focus as well. So see how that's done. I'll grab the cloud layer, make a copy of that. Whenever I'm actually modifying pixels on a layer, I always want to do it on a copy of that, so I can always go back to my original if I need to. Let's go ahead and apply just a slight blur to this. Blur, Gaussian blur, way down to the bottom here, and I'm just going to just kind of edge this up a little bit and just soften the focus of those clouds just a touch. There we go. So that makes them a little bit out of focus, which kind of matches this being out of focus. That's probably a bit too much. There we go. So our helicopter is in focus, everything behind it is out of focus, and it looks much more realistic, much more natural this way. So when you're doing this kind of photo retouching and changing skies, make sure you pay attention to the focus depth of your image. If your depth of focus is sharp in the front and then background images are less in focus, your new sky needs to be even less in focus than that background object. So that's what we're doing here. We're just kind of knocking the focus off of those clouds a little bit, and that makes it much more realistic looking. So here's the original clouds. It looks great, it looks real nice, but if anybody looks at it for a second, they're gonna say, wait a minute, those clouds are in focus and the buildings aren't. What's wrong with that? And the eye can catch those things. So like this, softening up the clouds a little bit pushes them back in focus, and now you're really focused visually on just that helicopter, and that's where we want our attention. So there we go. That's how we can improve this picture. There's the original. And we've improved it quite a bit because we have changed the sky, we've matched our focus, we've cleaned up the edges of the building, and we've also increased the color contrast between our foreground and our background, making the foreground pop a little bit more. So there it is. That's how you can change the sky in a photograph. Thank you for watching this special Photoshop photography project video. Don't forget to subscribe so that you will get first notice of new project videos in the future. Just click on this link right here where it says subscribe here. You can get all 12 project videos in this series, along with 26 special videos demonstrating the tools and techniques that I used in these projects, by clicking on this link right down here. And then thank you again for watching this